Have you ever wondered why iron is so important for us runners? Have you ever been diagnosed with an iron deficiency or anemia? Or have you ever wondered if you have one? If you have, you came to the right place. Stick around. Welcome to my channel. My name is Susie and I'm the host of I Run Things. I wanted to tackle this topic because I was diagnosed with an iron deficiency last year, right after I ran the Love Run half marathon in Philadelphia. So that was in March. I was diagnosed right after that. So at the end of March, I wasn't diagnosed with anemia. I was diagnosed with an iron deficiency. Now the standard measurement to find out if you have an iron deficiency or not is to measure your ferritin levels. That's what was low in my case. If you are a runner and you experience slower times or pains and aches or just a general unexplained tiredness, you should go to your doctor to get checked for either iron deficiency or anemia. Those are the two most common reasons why you would feel that way. So the standard to measure an iron deficiency is checking your ferritin levels. In my case, my ferritin levels were at 4, if I'm not remembering incorrectly. I don't know if it was 4 or 6. The minimum that a doctor recommends is 30. If you're a runner, your body may experience low ferritin levels differently, so you may need more than those 30 to really feel like you're running your best. So my recommendation, as always, is to consult with your family doctor when you're feeling this way. Each person is unique. You may feel tired for other reasons that are not a low iron or anemia. You really should, if you're feeling that way, you really should find out what the reasons for that are. You really shouldn't take a supplement unless you need one, because if you're taking supplements, iron supplements, and your iron levels are high, you may put your blood into iron toxicity, and that's not good at all. So that's why you should go to your doctor and get your blood work done. It is recommended that you take, for women, that you take 18 milligrams of iron through your diet. Now, if your doctor decides that you should be on an iron supplement, it helps tremendously for the absorption of that iron to take that iron supplement with something acidic, such as orange juice or even vitamin C. What's about running that creates, because there's a lot of women who are runners, they say that usually it's like 30% of women who run have an iron deficiency. So what's about running that makes it, makes us women so prone to an iron deficiency? So scientists think that athletes such as runners lose a lot of iron during their exercise, especially not so much when you're a sprinter, but when you are an endurance athlete. You lose iron when you sweat, and obviously when you're an endurance athlete, if you're running 3 hours, you're gonna lose more sweat than someone who just sprints for 50 meters. But also there's something called foot strike hemodialysis. When you are running, the pounding on the pavement, the pounding on the floor damages the red blood cells on the bottom of your feet and destroys those red blood cells. So the body needs to produce more, utilizes more iron to do so. And that's why we have an iron deficiency. So all in all, there's probably several factors why women tend to run low on iron when they're runners. Number one is the diet. We tend to be very conscious about what we eat. Number two, we lose iron through our sweat. And number three, the foot strike hemodialysis that I just referred to. Signs to look out for when your performance decreases and when you're feeling extremely fatigued, especially if it's not related to obvious reasons. If you're obviously running more, you're gonna feel more fatigued. But if you wake up in the morning and you're fatigued and you're always tired during the day, then you should get your iron checked. So this is it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful. I did a lot of research, and I will link down below some of the podcasts that I tried to condense in this short video for you guys. You're welcome to check them out to learn more about this topic. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe for more, and see you around. Happy running, guys.